those who fear you will be glad when they see me, because I trust in your word. I know, O Lord, that your judgments are right, and that in faithfulness you have afflicted me. Let your loving kindness be my comfort, as you have promised to your servant. Let your compassion come to me that I may live, for your law is my delight. Let the arrogant be put to shame, for they wrongly live lies, but I will meditate on your commandments. Let those who fear you turn to me, and also those who know your decrees. Let my heart be sound in your statutes, that I may not be put to shame. My soul has longed for your salvation. I have put my hope in your word. My eyes have failed from watching for your promise, and I say, when will you comfort me? I have become like another flask in the smoke, but I have not forgotten your statutes. How much longer must I wait? When will you give judgment against those who persecute me? The crowd have dug pits for me. They do not keep your law. All your commandments are true. Help me, for thy persecute me with lies. They had almost made an end of me on earth, but I have not forsaken your commandments. In your loving kindness revive me, that I may keep the decrees of your law. O Lord, your word is everlasting. It stands firm in thy heavens. Your faithfulness remains from one generation to another. You established the earth and it abides. By your decrees, these continue to this day. For all things are your servants. If my delight had not been in your law, I should have perished in my affliction. I will never forget your commandments, because by them you give me life. I wrote, oh, that you would save me, for I study your commandments. Though the wicked lie in wait for me to destroy you, I will apply my mind to your decrees. I see that all things come to an end, but your commandment has no bounds. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles, the first chapter, beginning at the first verse. In the first book of Theophilus, I have dealt with all that Jesus began to do and teach, until the day when he was taken up, after he had given commandment through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. Then he presented himself alive after his passion by many proofs, appearing to them during 40 days, and speaking of the kingdom of God. While staying with them, he charged them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, which he said, "You heard from me, for John baptized with water, but before many days you shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit." So when they had come together, they asked him, "Lord, will you at this time restore the kingdom to Israel?" He said to them, "It is not for you to know time or season which the Father has fixed by his own authority. You shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. You shall be my witness in Jerusalem, and in all Judea, and Samaria, and the end of the earth." When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him out of their sight. While they were gazing into the heaven as he went, behold, two men stood by them in white robes and said, "Men of Galilee, why do you stand looking into heaven? This Jesus who was taken up from you into heaven will come in the same way as you saw him and go into heaven." Then they returned to Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is near Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey away. And when they entered, they went up to the upper room, where they were saying, "Peter, John, James, Thomas, Bartholomew, and Matthew, James, the son of Alphinius, and Simon the Zealot, and Judas, the son of James. All these, with one accord, devoted themselves to prayer, together with the woman and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and with his brothers. Here ended the lesson. A reading from the Gospel according to Matthew, the 27th chapter, beginning at the 45th verse. From the sixth hour there was darkness over all the land, until the ninth hour. About the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani? That is, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? And some of the bystanders hearing it said, this man is calling Elijah. And one of them at once ran and took a sponge, filled with vinegar, put it on a reed, and gave it to him to drink. But the others said, wait, let us see whether Elijah will come to save him. And Jesus cried again with a loud voice, and yelled up his spirit. And behold, the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom, and the earth shook, and the rocks were split, the tombs also were opened, and many bodies of the saints who had fallen asleep were raised, and coming out of the tombs after his resurrection, they went to the holy city and appeared to many. When the centurion and those who were with him, keeping watch over Jesus, saw the earthquake and what took place, they were filled with awe and said, truly, this was the Son of God. Here ended the lesson.
Salvation. let thy way be known upon earth, thy saving will among all nations. Let nothing needy, O Lord, be forgotten, nor the hope of the poor be taken away. Create in us clean hearts, O God, and sustain us with thy Holy Spirit. O God, the protector of all that trust in thee, without whom nothing is strong, nothing is holy, increase and multiply upon us thy mercy, that thou being our ruler and guide, we may so pass through things temporal, that we find and lose not thy things eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. O God, from whom all holy desires, all good counsels, and all just works do proceed, give unto thy servants that peace which the world cannot give, that our hearts may be set to obey thy commandments, and also that by thee we, being defended from the fear of enemies, may pass our time in rest and quietness, for the merits of Jesus Christ our Savior. Amen. Light in our darkness we beseech thee, O Lord, and by thy great mercy defend us from all perils and dangers of this night. The love of thy only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Of the Father's love begotten, and the world's began to be, he is Alpha and Omega, he the source, the ending be, of the things that are that have been, and that future you shall see, evermore and
servants as may be best for us, creating us in this one home of thy truth.